welcome to the first ever edition of Sunrise. I'm Carly Flynn, and it's a pleasure and a privilege to be with you.
And I'm James Coleman. Here's what's ahead this morning.
We're live at the country's busiest port, where in 30 minutes workers will walk off the job for 2 days, all at a bad time for importers. More on that throughout the morning.
Then we're off to London as Helen Clark meets and greets European heavyweights en route to the Rugby World Cup.
All the glamorous spots this morning. We're in LA to meet our Hollywood guy, Nelson Aspin, who has all the latest dirt on Lindsay, Paris and Britney, along with the real movie stars too.
But first up, we're live in Paris. We'll have a look at the latest money news and take you through the country's main morning papers and give you the chance to win your way to the Rugby World Cup in France.
Nice to be here.
It is. I mean, it's like we've been holding this present for months.
And now our gift to you.
Have it. You are our inaugural viewers and nobody can take that away from you. You're there with us. Both of you.
No. Mum, Dad.
Through thick and thin. So they've, we've had a bit of thin. Thick later with Rod with sport. No, that's really bad. It's terrible, Rod. Sorry, the gloves are off. Right now, Sasha with Sunrise News.
Good morning. 250 dock workers are set to walk off the job at the country's biggest port in half an hour. Our reporter Ali Akram is at the ports of
and
Auckland.
That's it for news. Here's Rod with sport.
Thank you, Sasha. Yes, good morning. The All Blacks have arrived in Wales ahead of their quarterfinal showdown with France. They lost the marble-picking competition to stay at a hotel in town, so took a coach ride out to the Sticks. But there is still no word of But if cleared, it's not yet known which jersey Luaki will be wearing. There'll be a coin toss tomorrow to decide who has to wear the alternative strip. Marble picking, coin tossing, it's a bit random really, isn't it?
I don't understand. What's marble? What do you mean?
They choose marbles to see which hotel they're going to stay at in Wales, the one closest to the Millennium Stadium or the one out in the Sticks. And then,
well, it's hardly fair.
And they toss a coin for the
away
who
strip.
Wears black. Yeah.
Oh, well, I suppose it's 50-50, or is it?
And you called me thick this morning.
Right, touché.
The All Blacks are keeping quiet ahead of the quarterfinal.
Right, Josh, this has got to be a day for the weatherman. Are you there, Josh?
Good morning to you from central Auckland. Yes, where it's been a pretty wet and wild night. In fact, that's pretty much the situation for most of the country. So let's have a look at today's national weather forecast. There's a strong wind warning for Hawke's Bay and Wairarapa between Napier and Featherston. There will be gusts up to 120 kilometres per hour in exposed places, especially about the Takapo Plains. A ridge developing off Australia is allowing cold air from the South Pole to race up the country. That's causing isolated thunderstorms and hail when pushed over mountain areas. A colder front is also moving up the east coast of the South Island, bringing sleety showers to the deep south. So it's a wet start to the day in the south. Invercargill reaches just 10, while Queenstown and Oamaru get 13. Thundery showers are on the cards for the west coast, highs of 13 and 14, and southwesterly winds, 18 the high for Blenheim. It's extremely windy in the lower North Island, strong northerly gales for Palmerston North. There are showers for most other areas. Napier, Hastings and Gisborne get 20 degrees, and moving up north, the rain doesn't stop. Westerly winds and highs between 17 and 18 in the far north. Now, I've spoken to the Met Service and they say that this unsettled weather is likely to stretch right through to the end of the school holiday. So I think we're going to have to just get used to this one, I think.
Sit tight and watch sunrise, I reckon.
Exactly, or play PlayStation, whatever.
Thanks, Josh.
Thanks
for your vote of confidence. Well, you are with Sunrise this Tuesday morning, it is. We'll whip you across to Paris for all the mornings.
You can have your say on Sunrise. Your thoughts or suggestions are very welcome here.
Email us through our website, tv3.co.nz/sunrise, or you can text us, write Sunrise and your message and flick it on to 3330. Well, news, weather and sport are coming up for you on Sunrise. Then we're live in London with political editor Duncan Garner as our Prime Minister has her first meeting with her new British counterpart. And apparently it's not all beer and Skittles. Right now, though, take a look at this.
Hi, guys. We just wanted to wish you the very, very best of luck with this new venture.
Sunrise is coming.
Yeah, welcome. Welcome aboard, Sunrise.
Yeah. Hi, James.
Good luck for the show. I think it's going to work out well. Been doing a few figures here, looking at the word sunrise. You can rearrange the letters and get run sissy.
I am looking forward to waking up with sunrise because my children wake me at 5:30 every morning and I have no one to talk to at that time in the morning except a three-year-old.
We're really, really jealous about the set. It's really smart.
Yeah, it is.
Wow, I mean, this is such a huge honour. We're very humbled to receive this award today.
It's not an acceptance speech.
Rinse us. So, you know, in the morning, a lot of people obviously having showers and that sort of thing, so that fits quite nicely together.
Yes, it's sunrise. I better get to work. Yes, you better get to work.
It's for sunrise.
Well, they were.
They didn't win anything. It's like they're on air now, so we're welcoming them onto the, you know, onto the schedule.
We've been watching you kind of get ready over the past couple of weeks. You're going to do a brilliant job.
Sunrise tomorrow takes you live to London, Paris and Hollywood.
We'll meet a rugby-loving Austin Powers impersonator and
And of course you can get Sure Sin, and I'm sure there's going to be a lot of that on the show. Good luck.
Beautiful looking blue morning in Christchurch there. Wow,
that'd be Wellington, wouldn't it? That'd be Wellington. Sorry. That would be Wellington.
That would be Wellington.
I'm sure there's one of those in Christchurch though somewhere. They're all around the place, the war memorials. Anyway, lovely day in Wellington. Welcome.
Thank you for clarifying, James. Well, emos, goths, rockers, not so much your country and western fans, but a fair few musical genres are represented at the upcoming Big Day Out.
The latest lineup have just been unveiled. Tickets go on sale next Friday. Kate Roger has the first look at who the big names are. She joins us from Kay Rhodes Rock Shop. Hi, Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Hello, my lovelies. It's so good to see you. We've waited so long and you're looking absolutely gorgeous.
Tell us who's coming to Auckland January 20-ish something.
Yeah, January 18th this year, actually, Carly, Friday. Tickets go on sale next Friday, October 12th. We are so lucky. You two and all our inaugural Sunrise viewers are, in fact, the very first in the country to find out who the Big Day Out headliners are going to be. This is the first of a couple of big announcements, but today is the first big one. So thanks to the Big Day Out guys for coming to Sunrise, and it's going to be cool. The first big headliner, Björk. Now, if you've ever had a chance to see the Icelandic hamster perform live, she is absolutely amazing. She is awesome. She's coming down with her big beats. She's also bringing her big brass section with her as well, and she's going to be great. Now, I'm old enough to remember Rage Against the Machine when they played Big Day Out. I don't know. I don't even know, want to know how long ago. And they are coming back. Now, these guys know how to rock a stadium. James, you would have been at Rage Against the Machine at the Big Day Out, wouldn't you?
I don't know that I was. Was that 1996? I think it was.
It was 96. The was the first one, 95? Might have been the first one.
Yeah, 96, I'm pretty sure it was. In fact, I'm sure Campbell Smith is the Big Day Out organiser, and he's in fact will be able to tell us when.
Thanks,
they,
guys.
When
you heard it here first. Thanks, Kate.
Thanks so much,
more to
Kate.
Come. Hey, just before we go on, we've had a couple of texts and more emails coming in this morning. One texter has raised a very good point, James. Sunrise, the show looks awesome, thank you. Hope you're getting a decent deal on coffee. Early starts, ouch.
That's a very good point.
No, we're not.
I tell you what, the cafe makes quite a good cup of coffee. Let's not poo-poo them.
No, absolutely
not. Sure, send us your coffee if you think we need it. This is from Dylan. Great job, guys. Always been a fan of your work, James. Do I have to read this one? Yeah. I can't read this one.
I'll pat you on the back for you. Is there a possibility of starting up the old Coleman sessions to TV?
Well, isn't that what we're doing?
Yeah, it kind of is, really, in a way.
Thanks, Dylan.
Hey team, love the new show. It's sick in the fridge. The live feed from Paris is awesome. I'll be watching every morning. Hamish Wilson, thanks very much, Hamish. Cheers. Sick in the fridge.
We'll have a bit more of that a bit later in the show.
Okay, this is where we explain the tenuous link between Austin Powers and the Rugby World Cup. Imagine, if you will.
And I'll be back with 3 News at 12.
Thanks, Sasha. Well, that is Sunrise for this Tuesday morning. Thanks for being with us on our first day. We'll be back tomorrow from 6:30 and hope you will be too.
But for now, from the whole Sunrise team,
have a great day.